দিলাম ছাড়িও গুরু তোমারি নামে। ওইবারে আমি যদি ডুবে মরি কলঙ্ক তো মার নামে, তোমারে নামে। বাজারিরা বাজার করে কত রঙের বাতি জ্বলে গুরু মোকামের সামনে, বাজার করে।
নমস্কার, আমার নাম সুদেশনা হাজরা। গুড ইভিনিং, I'm Sudeshna Hazra and I come all the way from Calcutta with a show of images just for you. 8400 miles is a long, long way when a woman comes leaving her hearth and kins all behind with her loved one to share love, magic and weave a colorful kingdom for themselves. Perhaps it starts from the old proverb that talks of the heart growing fonder every day with increasing distance. And I felt that when I went back this time for my vacation just about 5 weeks ago to my motherland to capture all of it, its colors, its essence, its culture, its people in my lenses. Image making is one of my hobbies for the last 4 years, right from the time I stepped into Uncle Sam's land. When I was a little girl, my grandmother would tell me tales of a golden fortress amidst the desert. And that golden fortress was an eye candy in the desert. I always wanted to see this golden fortress myself, but somehow, all the 25 years that I spent in my country, I never managed to get there. This time, when I went back for my vacation, I made it a point to go visit that. A basic fortress made of limestone. But it becomes a thing of beauty, a real marvel. When the sun shines on it, it actually is then a Byzantine golden piece. And when the sand dunes settle down around, it is enthralling to the eye. Whenever I would throw my tantrums as a little girl, my mother would tell me tales of elephant rides. Elephants are gorgeous creatures. They are tame and easily domesticated. And they are beautiful when you want to ride on them because they are quiet, they settle down, they wait until people actually mount on them, and then they are on. And people who've been on them have often mentioned that they are not as bumpy as camels. So that settles it then. My mom said, "Your groom shall appear before your eyes on your wedding day on an elephant." But then we were all settled in a city. No elephants could charter there. This time, when I was walking across one of the fortresses, I noticed an elephant. and definitely there was somebody riding it. Probably they are some of the few who can only afford elephant rides these days, and that too in the areas of fortresses. On my way to a bazaar, I actually came across a couple of minstrels. Now, I have to explain to you what these traditional minstrels would be all about. Usually, a couple, a man and his woman, would weave a minstrel band. Out of them, one would be the singer and the other would be the musician. And they would narrate tales of their land or of the lands they've been chartering in their past few days, months, weeks or years. They were telling wonderful tales of their own village and their home. Maro Gam Katha Pareja. It's a traditional song that talks of one's hearth and how beautiful it is, and with whatever humble beginnings, surroundings they have, they'd like to welcome everybody. Indians love tourists, and that's what they've been singing around. When I returned home from the minstrels, I definitely had to tell my mother what I had just captured. And to my surprise, my mother, who has turned a little older than I knew her when I last saw her, started dancing to the song which I had recorded on my phone. She's still a very, very graceful dancer, and I have to show you some of the images which were charming when she was as young as me. Bengalis have a fetish for fishes. No matter what kind of fish it is, they have to consume at least one piece of fish every night and every day. If they don't have fish, they tell themselves, well, oxygen is not reaching my brains. What do I do? How do I survive? And how do I work? They are one hell lazy set of people, unless you feed them right and unless you love them the right way. So I have to take you to a fish market to understand the voracious marketeers as well as the vociferous fishmongers who cry out with their large pieces of fish just to attract more and more buyers. Here's a glimpse at our fish market.
Thank you.
comes to food, I have to tell you the story how my spices and my recipes were really loved by one of my friends here, and she had to cook this up for her husband on one of her anniversary dates. You have to see this to believe me. Jewelry is a favorite thing with women all around the world. Even Indian women love different kinds of jewelry. Now, when I talk of jewelry, it does not always mean precious metals like gold, silver, platinum, or precious stones like rubies or diamonds. I would also talk of these wonderful jewelry sellers who make jewelries out of crude metals, out of baked earth, much like the one that I am wearing, and also made out of dried vegetation like leaves and grasses. Oasis, or a patch of green in a desert, has always been interesting. Now, when I talk of an oasis in India, it is not just a patch of green, but actually a natural lake in Udaipur. Isn't that amazing? You have to see these images to believe your eyes. And there's also a few hills as a result of which the climatic condition in and around this little area is a lot better than what we actually find in the desert. It's not as good as a hill station probably, but it's very close. And then you have beautiful palaces, one right in the middle of the lake, much like an island, and the other, the city palace, on the banks of the lake. That makes this place a real thing of beauty.
Bhai Sara Biram Hane Bihari Ala Chala Sa Bhai Sara Biram Hane Bihari ala chalo sa Bihari ere mhane olu haave Bihari ere mhane olu haave
Fun started when I went into the desert, actually riding on a bumpy camel, and met the gypsies right at the heart of our desert.
Sharia balamo
gypsies usually reside in tents or in little muddy huts. And surprisingly, these gypsy women are capable of handling 8 different sized earth-baked pots, and they mount each of these pots one on top of the other right over their head, and they bring in waters from miles away from a nearest oasis. And surprisingly, they can even dance to various tunes on their way back. Now you have to understand that these tunes are so enamoring, so charming, so lively that it can bring out a dancer in all of us. Mother and daughter have an amazing relationship back in India, and one of their better days are spent basking in sunshine, where a mom often oils her daughter's hair. This was an image that was almost lost when I left India about 4 years ago, and I was very, very happy to find this back again, this time right at the threshold of my house. Sarojini Naidu, often called as the Nightingale of India, had written a wonderful poem about our bazaars named In the Bazaars of Hyderabad. Now, she writes about our colourful wares that she's always found on display. These bazaars are not the ones that you'd possibly see in supermarkets, malls, and places like them. They're all about colourful wares like embroidered pieces, adorned glass pieces, colourful jewellery, colourful umbrellas, colourful jutis, or these little shoes made out of different kinds of fabric and are often embroidered to give them a regal look. Here's a glimpse of those bazaars. Religion and faith find their way into our lives and weave them intricately in some way or the other. When we talk of India, no story can be complete without mentioning its religion, especially Hinduism, that has more than 100 gods and goddesses. Naturally, each of them have a favorite or a set of favorites whom they follow and whose rituals they always observe. Brahma Lake, one of the most popular temples in Rajasthan, happened to have a lot of followers, and they're all worshippers of Brahma, the creator, and Saraswati, the knowledge provider. In the lake, they often pay homages to their ancestors, and it is a way of feeling close to their roots. We'll now have a quick glimpse at how religion intricately binds every Indian.
Randa samunga deso.